Hi everyone, Saeed here. Today I'm going to show you how to design the parallax effect in PowerPoint. First, let's check it out. As you see, this effect is very charming and it is very easy to design. You can use any picture you like. For example, you can add a portrait as background or a specific picture. These animations are continuous and attractive and will grab the attention of your audience instantly. They are so amazing, so let's design them together. Let's start by drawing a rectangle. Set its height to 7.5 and width to 4.65. Hold the Ctrl key down and duplicate it. Now I want to rotate this shape 5 degrees. To do that, right-click on the shape and select Format Shape. In this window, select Size and Properties, and in the Size section, rotate your shape 5 degrees. Also, for better view, increase the transparency of the shape. Alright, now increase the height of rectangle a little bit to cover the below shape and drag it to the left. Now select both shapes and from the Shape Format tab, in the Merge section, select Fragment. We don't need this part, so delete it. From the Insert tab, select the trapezoid and draw it. Set the height to 7.5 and width to 6.5. And by using the yellow dot, decrease the length of the upper side. Now, draw a rectangle and cover half of the trapezoid with it. Select the trapezoid first, then the rectangle, and subtract rectangle from it. Select these two shapes, then hold the Shift key down and rotate them 180 degrees. Also, flip this one horizontally. Let's add a drop shadow to all the shapes. Press Ctrl A to select all the shapes, then in this window, add a drop shadow in this direction to all of them. Set the transparency to 50, blur to 35, and the distance to 12. Also, let's remove the outline from them. Now I have to manage layers. Click on the Arrange icon and select the selection pane. In this window, we can manage all the layers. For example, I want this shape to be at the bottom. First, change its name to 1, then drag its layer down. I want this one in the middle, so change its name to 2 and drag its layer to the middle. This one is already at top, so only change its name to 3. Now select all the shapes and align them to the right and put them exactly on this side. While all of them are selected, hold the Ctrl and Shift keys down and make another copy of them. Flip them horizontally and align them to the left. Now drag them exactly to this side. Don't forget to change the direction of drop shadow. Change it to this direction with the same properties. I mean transparency 50, blur 35, and distance 12. Let me change the background color. White color is burning my eyes. Click on the background and choose any color you like. Now draw a rectangle and cover the entire slide with it. Remove its outline and send it back. Also, if you like, change its color. Okay, so far so good. Now we have to prepare for the animations. Press Ctrl A to select all the shapes, then from the Animation tab, add the Grow animation to all of them. Click on the Animation pane, and while all the animations are selected, right-click on one of them and select Timing. In this window, select Start with Previews and increase its duration to 5 seconds. Since I want this animation to repeat continuously, I have to select until the end of a slide in the Repeat section. Now, select the Effect tab and decrease the size of zoom to 120%. Increase the smooth start and smooth end to 1.5 seconds. Also check the Auto Reverse option and click on OK. Alright, now we have to add the line animation to all the shapes one by one. I am going to start with this shape. So select it and add the line animation to it. By default, it goes down, but we have to change its direction to the right. If I click on this red arrow, you can see the preview of its movement. As you see, the path it takes is too long. So hold the shift key down and drag this little red circle to the left. Okay, this much is good. Let's add the line animation to the middle shape. I want to animate it to the left and also decrease its path. At the end, we have to add the line animation to the bottom shape. Change its direction to right and decrease its path. Now we have to add the line animation to the left shapes. But keep in mind, if this shape's direction is right, and if you want a symmetric movement, you have to choose left for this one. Alright, I have added the line animation to all the shapes, and we have to modify their properties. So select the first line animation in the animation pane, then hold the shift key down and select the last one. As you see, all the line animations are selected. Right click on one of them and select timing. In this window, select start with previews and set the duration to 5 seconds and repeat until end of a slide. Go to the effect tab, then set the smooth start and smooth end to half a second and check the auto reverse option. Now your PowerPoint is almost ready. Let's check it out. It is beautiful already, but since we haven't filled the background with a picture, we can't see the parallax effect properly. In this section, I'm going to show you how to set a picture as background properly. But before that, let me tell you that you can download the template for free in the description. And at the end of this video, I will explain how to use the template. But if you like this video so far, please like and subscribe to the channel and ring the notification bell for additional upcoming videos. Alright, let's get back to the video. Right now, all the shapes have solid fill, but I want to fill them with the background fill. If you notice, the background color is purple. So if I select all the shapes and in the fill section choose a slight background fill, you can see that all the shapes are filled with the background color, which is purple. But what if I fill the background with a picture? For example, I bring my picture to the slide and I want to set this picture as background. To do that, press Ctrl X to cut the picture and click once in the outside to activate the format background window. In the fill section, select picture or texture fill, then click on clipboard to paste the picture as background. You can see that all the shapes are filled with the background picture. Now I have to add my title. From the insert tab, click on the text box and add your title. You might ask, what is this text effect? Let me explain it in another video, because this video is getting long already. Anyway, now if I preview the slide, you can see this stunning parallax effect. Let me open the template and explain how to use it. This is the template, and I have designed four different slides for you. As you see, all the backgrounds are filled with blue. The only thing that you have to do is to bring your picture to the slide and press Ctrl X to cut it, then right click in the outside and select Format Background. In this window, select Picture or Texture Fill, then click on the clipboard to paste your picture as background. Now your PowerPoint is ready. If your animation was a little laggy, save your PowerPoint and close it. Open your PowerPoint again, and you won't see that lagginess anymore.